Welcome back, trainers, and in this video we're going to be taking a look at Xerneas yet again because it is that good and it's still here. You better get it while it's hot because this is definitely something that you want in your arsenal with the best IV possible if you're going to be using it in Master League, of course. Now I did go with this one that I do have here because it's shiny and the lower IVs are going to be in HP and it's going to be 11 and I'm perfectly fine with that. That's just something I do over here. As long as it's got 15 in attack and defense, we're looking okay. So with that said, if you do enjoy my videos, give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you're new, turn notifications on. We're going to be pairing it up with Groudon, 100% IV, and it's going to be Best Buddy equipped because I have still yet to get my Dialga to Best Buddy. I don't know why, maybe because it's just that 1 point off from 100, I feel like it's not worthy. That should be more incentive to do it, right? So anyway, we got the Groudon in the lead and Dialga on the team as well, and we're going to have a blast here. So after powering it up, let's see what happens. Okay, so I'm thinking, I already knew how well it was able to take Iron Head before, so let's go ahead and just see how well it does. Now, I do shield up this first one here, because I do want to kind of just maintain my health. I know they're going to get to another one, because although you can generate energy pretty fast, I suppose, with Xerneas, and it's quick move, buffed quick move, it's still taking you a minute, all right? You're still going to be sitting out there vulnerable. So we're able to survive. Great. Going to go for the close combat, take out the Dialga, and we're going to quick move down the Zacian. My fairy wins. Let's go. All right, next battle, we're going to be met with a rival ground type, which is going to be Garchomp here. This thing can put up a fight. It's not like, oh, I'm just going to run over it. Yep. It looks like we're a lot bigger, but Garchomp is no joke. So they're hitting us with Earth Power, doing a ton of damage. They just need to hit us with one more to take us out here. Shielding up the Earthquake. I do believe they double shield this, if I recall this correctly here. So seeing that they did go for Earth Power, I would assume they got Earth Power and Outrage, so we're going to be good there. Anyways, we're getting two shields out of them. Great. Sounds good. Now, what we could do at this point is shield this up and get to the Earthquake, but what I'm going to do is go ahead and let it go. Now, Dialga's taking super effective from the Earth Power. We could farm them down with Dragon Breath, but we're more than likely going to have to shield an Earth Power. Absolutely going to have to shield one. So we bring in the Xerneas here, and we're just going to go ahead and absorb that. They do swap into a Lugia, which kind of left me a little bit stumped here. So we're going to go ahead and obviously throw the Moonblast, retreat into our Dialga, and this, you know, we've already showcased Lugia. It can hold its own, and it is going to be able to do a lot of damage. So I do decide to shield this up, knowing that they're going to probably go in for that Aeroblast, which would have done a ton, so we shield that up correctly. Farm a little bit extra so we can have some energy ready to go for whatever we have to be ready for. And it is going to be that Garchomp in perfect. So we're able to get to another Iron Head here. The question is, what do they have in the back? And it is going to be their own Dialga. So this is going to be pretty crazy here, folks. And this is why I just love this shiny Xerneas so much. It just puts in the work here. So we're going to almost make it to the Draco. Unfortunately not. And bring in our Xerneas. Can we get to the close combat? And we do. And this will be enough to KO. Coming in clutch for us. And again, I'm getting my return in my investment for this thing. Absolutely. It hasn't let me down. There's been situations where it's just like, okay, well, I lose, but it's not this thing's fault. It's not like, ah, what a waste of Stardust. Absolutely not. Definitely great. So we're going to be making a swap into our Dialga. They bring in their Excadrill here. Now I'm hoping that we're going to be able to land this Draco without them shielding up. Let's see if we're going to be able to do though. And we are getting it through. Fantastic. They just let it go, and that's all I really needed to come back from this battle here. So we're obviously going to be bringing in Xerneas and having a little fun here. Now, they could have Flash Cannon, which would be devastating, but it is going to be Brutal Hammer. It seemed a little bit soon there, and they're still going. We're not going to be going for close combat because we do not want to lower our defense quite yet. They're letting it go. What do they have in the back? A Metagross, so I immediately swap into my Groudon. And it's still a 2-2 shield situation here. And in that situation, the Groudon will win 100% of the time. And they already knew. They already backed out at this point. We're just throwing this before we see that not connect. And we take the win. Let's get it. That's what I'm talking about. I can't wait to get this Xerneas 2 best buddy and completely maxed out here. All right, next battle, we're met with a best buddy. Speak of it. Buzzwole. Okay. So fire is still super effective. And as long as we get this off before they hit us with a lunge, and we're getting a shield. Great, perfect. That's great. Lunge is going to do a decent amount. We just showcased this Buzzwole level 50 and best buddy, 100% IV, and it does put in the work here. So we can't just treat it like nothing because we do have the Dialga in the back. Landing that Fire Punch, doing a ton of damage. They're going to be throwing before we get to our next one. They've already used a shield, which is fine. Now, Xerneas is going to completely wall this with the moves that it does have. Bug and fighting are both going to be resisted here. So what they could do is throw the lunge and at least lower our attack just like that. Yep. And just go down with the ship. But what I'm going to do is throw this before they get to another one because I don't want them to debuff me that much quite yet. So we throw the play rough and they bring in their Metagross. We immediately swap into our Dialga here. And all we have to look out for is... we got to look out for the earthquake, as we all know, right? Stating the obvious. All right, so we're shielding it up correctly. That's great. So we're not going to, you know, expect an earthquake after they go for a meteor mash. We do throw Iron Head thinking that they might shield up, but they don't. And they have a... Yveltal in the back. So as much as I wanted to go for the Draco here, we're going to go for the Iron Head and hope we get a shield and they're letting it go, which is still fine because we've already got them low enough to basically tackle down with Xerneas. Tackle's still doing a lot of damage. They're letting it go, bringing in that Metagross, which kind of confused me. I felt like if they shielded up the Yveltal, I don't know. I just, at this point, I just said, I'm going to shield up Dialga and just Dragon Breath you down with not very effective Dragon Breath. And we take that win. Let's go. Moving on to our next battle. Met with an Excadrill. And you already know this is a fantastic lead for us here. So we're just going to wait for them to potentially swap. There it is. Bringing in a Dragonite. And we're going to build up a little bit of extra energy. Actually, what happened there? I just got confused for a second. I was like, should I go Dialga or Xerneas? Go Xerneas. No question about it. But I wanted to farm a little extra. It kind of just processed all that really quick there. And if you haven't hit that like button, make sure you do so. I really do appreciate it when you hit that there. Makes me pretty happy and it shows me you like the content. And yeah, just all in all, it's just the best thing you can do for the channel. So we're taking down their Dragonite, building up a little bit of extra energy so we can go for a close combat here, letting the Drill Run go and making it to the close combat on the Excadrill. Do they let it go? And everybody already knows what moves we have, so it's not going to be a surprise. Now we retreat with the Xerneas and bring in our Groudon, go straight for the Earthquake up against the Dialga. We still have two shields left, getting to the Fire Punch. This Groudon is putting in the damn work and said, you will not pass. And we're taking that win. We're getting another back out. Let's go. This Xerneas team is looking freaking great. Moving it on here. Met with a Zacian. We've been here 100 times. We already know this is a fine matchup. Now, if they do have close combat and wild charge, that's even better. That was a little bit quick, so I'm thinking, yeah, they don't have, well, I can't say they don't have wild charge, but they're throwing close combat and bringing in their Kyogre, going straight for the hard counter, and we're going to go ahead and bring in our Dialga to just pretty much, you know, wouldn't say if they have Blizzard, it's going to take us out in one shot, so yeah, but we did a lot of damage already, bring them down fairly low. So we're going to go ahead and let this go. It is going to be a Blizzard. Perfectly fine. I was expecting that. They had enough energy for it. So we're ready to go. Bringing back Kyogre, or bringing back Groudon up against Kyogre. Getting a shield with Fire Punch. Yeah, that's what you love to see. Going for a Fire Punch and taking out Kyogre. Well, with one more quick move. That's something you don't see every day. And they're bringing back their Dialga. We make it to the Earthquake here, and it's all up to the Xerneas. Can we pull it off with it in the end here? They let the Earthquake go, and they have that Zacian in the beginning. So we still have two shields left here. No matter what they have, we're going to let this first one go because we'll still be able to survive that quick move, which is going to be not very effective. And this is going to about wrap it up, folks. If you did enjoy this video, give it a thumbs up. Zacian 100% worth going out there and getting. Thank you for watching and take care.
The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
So you're finally here! Fantastic!